Good morning, good morning, good morning. Thank you so much for showing up for the space. An artist spotlight with Andrea. We're so excited. Hosting with me, we have the one and only Majemel Matt. And so we're very excited. Hello there. Hi, Matt.
Good morning, Annie. Good morning, Andrea. How are you guys doing?
So well, good morning, Andrea. Can you hear us? Oh, let's see. Oh. I had invited her to speak and I thought she was already connected. And I guess it's happening now. Hi, Andrea. Can you hear us?
Hello, hello. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Fantastic. I'm at the train station right now, so I just want to make sure that you all can hear me.
We hear you loud and clear. Very, very exciting. Hey, friends, if you would and take a moment to just retweet the space, invite some friends to come on in if you feel able to that. If not, we'll have this interview with Andrea, and then afterwards we have a Q&A. We'll welcome anyone afterwards for the Q&A. In the meantime, if you're able to post a little GM here at our group chat or the chat that's at the bottom. If you have any questions, you want to highlight something that Andrea has said throughout her conversation, you're welcome to do that there. Anything that we post on top, we'll post it there on the thread where it lives on, even after our conversation. If you want to keep this conversation going on our Discord, you are welcome to do that through the Light Art Discord. And in the meantime, before we get started, just want to say thank you so much for being here and for all the guests that are showing up to be here and to listen to this artist spotlight. We are very excited. Thank you, Andrea, for joining. Matt.
Well, thank you so much. I apologize. I'm at the train station, so if it's a little bit noisy in the background, to at least get on the train, I apologize. But I'm very happy to be here, and thank you so much for inviting me. I couldn't miss it. I didn't want to miss it. I was like, I don't care that I'm going on a train. I still want to be here. It's very much appreciated, and I cannot wait to get started.
You are amazing, and we're so grateful that you've taken the time to be here. So thank you.
Such dedication. I love it. So no, actually, Andre, it sounds good. The sound quality is great. So don't worry about that. We should be good to go. So Annie, should I ask the first question or do you do a bio, an introduction first? I'm kind of new at this.
Yeah, usually I have a bio and introduction. I don't have a bio for Andrea. However, what we do know about Andrea is that she is an amazing artist, self-portrait work as well as AI kind of work. And so she has an amazing collection and collab work that she has done. As well, she is part of the Join team. And so we will hear a little bit more about her, but we posted her pinned tweet on top. So please give her a follow. If you're not following Andrea already, please give her a follow and follow along our conversation. Our little group chat at the bottom is live, so you can GM, you can have conversation as we're talking, or post something that you thought was interesting that she said, and we would highlight that. So thank you so much. Yeah, so we can get started. Matt, first question.
Hey Andrea, it's great to meet you. I'm really excited to learn join. So I'm really looking forward to it. Can you tell us a little bit about how you started creating art and how you've developed your artistic vision?
Absolutely. Well, first of all, thank you again for having me. And I see lots of familiar faces in the audience, some of my friends. Thank you all so much for being here. I find it interesting when I get asked, to talk about my art, my journey. I'm so used to hosting spaces, doing live streams, talking with other artists and hearing from them. And it's a totally different ball game when you're put in the position to talk about you and your work. So bear with me as I kind of go along with this, but I started Crown and Palette, I believe, maybe 4 years in April of 2020. I actually decided to finally d do something with my artistic abilities and actually open up my own business, start my artistic journey during the pandemic. And I started off with just knowing how much I love spirituality, astrology, and women empowerment. I always knew I loved each of these subjects, and I would just see images in my head all the time. I get visions, I get downloads quite often. And I came across collage art on Instagram, and I was following actually a few artists that are here in this space. I've been following them for such a long time. They've inspired me more ways than one. And I said to myself, why can't I do that too? I feel like I just need to just sit down and just learn, how do I do this? And I learned Photoshop in a very short period of time. When I'm somebody where if I really, really want something and I really want to learn something, I will go to the nitty gritty and I will study, I will practice. And I still do that to this day. So I fell in love with collage art, and that's how I started here in the space as well. So all of us, there was a big group of us on Instagram, and we're like, let's jump into this world. And I was like, why not? I have nothing to lose, right? I have a background in IT, actually. I work full-time outside Web3, for those who are not aware. I work as a project manager for an IT company, so I have a very large IT background. So that has helped me a lot in terms of trying to understand blockchain, crypto, because I had no idea what that was when I first entered the space, and I kind of had to figure it out as I went. So in terms of, you know, how it's evolved over from the beginning of the space when I joined around March of 2021 to about now, it'll be 3 years in March, which is actually not that far away if you think about it, which is kind of insane. It's really evolved. And I think what's really helped me evolve from just my collage art, I do more than that now. I've decided to finally venture into becoming the subject in some of my own work. So as you saw in the first tweet that you pinned above, which I really appreciate, I did a collaboration with Barb, who's a 3D artist, and I've been doing more self-portraiture work. I work with a photographer, and I have the full commercial rights, and I started to just put myself at the forefront of my work. And it took time for that. I can get into that at some point in time throughout the space, but it was something I was always scared of doing in the beginning, until when I entered the space, everyone's like, Andrea, why are you not putting yourself as the subject of the work? And I'm like, I don't know, I guess it's fear. And so I feel like being in this space has allowed me to come out of my shell and really kind of come out of my comfort zone in a lot of ways. So give me 1 second. I just need to get my ticket. 1 sec.
While you're getting your ticket, that's very cool. I think, for a second, it's just a reminder how quickly the space is moving. She began her journey only 3 years ago, and if you look at her works, it's evolved so much. And she's happening in AI. When she comes back, hopefully we'll get her to talk a little bit more about that as well. Annie, any thoughts?
I absolutely love the self-portrait work. As a self-portrait photographer in this space, I know how difficult and challenging it could be, one, to be in front of your lens, but then to think of logistics behind that. And so I love your work. I absolutely am drawn to that first piece that we pinned. I think your collab work is amazing. The vibe that you have there is really great, and the concept too. So I think you're doing a fantastic job, and we can all learn your thoughts behind this. If you don't mind sharing a little bit about that collab work that you have up on your pin tweet, there's 6 one-of-one pieces, and this, I'm assuming you're the model, and then there's a photographer, but you can go into that if you like.
Yeah, absolutely. So this is my second showcase I've done on Join. So, and I will talk about Join eventually. When I originally did yes, I do work with a photographer. I will make that very, very clear. I am not a photographer. I do work with one here in Ottawa, where I am currently in Canada. And he's just one of the most coolest people I know. I always have crazy ideas, and like, I was like, let's just play around with this. And so I knew I wanted thing around Halloween, not per se like to be a Halloween, but I love Halloween for so many reasons. And one of the reasons is it allows me to really bring out my alternate personas, like that alter ego. And so I feel like, why not try to do something with that? So last year I did Fallen Angel, and that was very successful for my first self-portraiture collection I've ever done. So I was like, okay, I need to try and top this this year. How am I going to top last year? And what really started it actually was I was in Italy not long ago. I was in Italy in May. It was my first time to Europe ever, and I knew I was going to be very much inspired for the 10 days that I was there. I even got to meet Odyssey of the Heart. For those who know who Pierre Andre is, he's one of my best friends here in the space, and I got to meet him in person, and I legit was like a crybaby. I was just so happy. So when I was there, I was in Venice actually, and for those who know a little background of culture wise in Venice, that masquerades are a big thing. And so there was this one cute mask shop where this lady makes all these handmade, like I'm seriously, this entire shop was full of masks, and they were gorgeous. Like every single one of them were so beautiful, and I was really drawn to this one black one. And this black one, it just prompted the idea of, I think I'm gonna be something with this mask. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna be a bad bunny this year, but not in like a Playboy bunny kind of way. In a way where like I wanted it to be this character that I've always had within me, like again, that alter ego that I wanted to share with the world. And I just didn't know how to do that yet. And so when I was talking to Barb is also one of my really good friends in the space. She's from Argentina. I got to meet her in real life at NFT NYC in the spring. And she's like, we should do a collaboration. And I said, yeah, you know what? I think this is going to work. Because Barb, for those who don't know Barb, she does a lot of amazing 3D work, and she's also huge into digital fashion. And she's like, girl, how about we have you as the model, and I can create 3D fashion garments on you? And I was like, you can do that? You can do that? What? So that's what we did. So I went to a very public place. Like, when I say public, it was very public. It was an outdoor shoot. It was not indoor. It was not in a studio. It was actually in a staircase near Parliament in Ottawa, Canada. And I can tell you for certainty that there was at least 100 people that passed me while I was wearing, you know, at the time I was only wearing like underneath like black shorts with the tube top and my outfit, but not the dresses and everything are completely made out of 3D. So her and I decided together, you know, what poses we're looking at, the angling and whatnot. So she needed to know and under to know what the photographer, my photographer, was doing in terms of his lighting. I had to take a picture of the scene itself so that she can capture the lighting perfectly with 3D. And a lot of people had no clue. I still laugh about it. Everyone's like, "Where's the 3D part?" And that's the beauty of just how talented Barb is. Like she really matched the lighting of each of the outfits onto me like a glove. I still am blown away every time I look at it. But as you in the link actually, if you actually go to the pinned tweet at the top, the link to the showcase actually shows you behind the scenes. If you haven't seen the behind the scenes of how we put it together, it's probably going to blow your mind. So you're welcome. I'm giving you a little heads up now. But
It
results were really
totally is
important to
blowing
really
my
emphasize
mind.
it.
I was just reiterating that it is blowing my mind. The video behind the scenes and the way the 3D objects and how they applied the outfit to your imagery. I think it's impressive. Anyways, I'm sorry, continue.
Barb is actually here in the audience as well. So I want to give a shout out to my collab partner, my queen, my girl. She is quite honestly one of the most talented artists I know. And I still like I get emotional even thinking about just how honored I am to have worked with her and to put this together. There's no way this could have happened. Like I wish those outfits were real. Like if I could manifest anything, I want to manifest those outfits to be real because I would rock them in real life. But it really came down to just really emphasizing the importance of our alter ego and really embracing that. Because I feel like for such a long time, I've been hiding behind being in the studio. I didn't always like, I wanted people to know that I like to model and I like to express myself in that way. But I also was scared to do that. Because, like, you know, I guess for some people, like, what are you trying to be, a wannabe model? You're trying who you're trying to be. And you know, a lot of people are really skeptical and people are very judgmental towards that. And I've been modeling for a long time. I've always found an excuse to work with a photographer and just do shoots, and not understanding why I liked doing them at the time. But now that I look at it, I'm like, it was my way of bringing out my other, my multifaceted being of multiple personas that I have within myself. And Lola is one of them. And she's been hiding for over a decade. And I finally decided, you know what? No, she's out. Cat's out of the bag now. She's out 100% now. And I'm just fully embracing that. And it's allowing me to be in my feminine, allowing me to like just feel that empowered side of myself and just stepping into my power. So that's what it was about.
That's super cool, Andrea. I love it. I love the hearing the maybe the inner challenges or struggles, and maybe there was some fear there, maybe not, but you know, you were strong and you pushed through it, and you moved on to something that you probably weren't real comfortable with at first. And now you're, I mean, isn't that truly what, you know, that's true artistry, right? I mean, that's super cool. I'm really excited to hear that. I think that's really great. I'm going to go off script just a little bit here, but do you find that Web3 has maybe made this journey and the ability to show who you are easier than maybe in a traditional trad art would have, or do you think there are other challenges, right? So talk about like how Web3 has helped or hindered this journey of yours.
100% Web3 has allowed me to completely, utterly embrace who I am and to express myself creatively in ways that I could not do in a traditional art world. Even prior to being on Instagram, I feel like Instagram still is in a lot of ways very limiting. At least that's just my experience. It may not be like that for everyone. But at least for me, because I'm in such a niche, my niche is astrology, spirituality, and women empowerment. So if it's kind of like outside of what I've been doing previously, my audience doesn't really fully understand. At least that's just gauging from my experience. And if I do venture and try new things, I don't always get the same kind of reaction, which is okay. I'm not expecting everyone to love everything I'm doing all the time. But when I introduce something new in web, like here on Twitter, on X, sorry, I'm so still used to saying Twitter. But when I'm on X and I get to share new things that I'm doing, there's something about this community that is always embracing and is allowing me and really accepts everything that I'm doing that's different. Even from like, I just don't feel that same resistance as I do outside of Web3. And that's one of the biggest reasons I'm still here, is because y'all helped me grow. Y'all helped me evolve. Y'all helped me get outside of my comfort zone and do something different. Like, I have all these crazy ideas, and every single time I share a crazy new idea, all of you are just so accepting and just loving it. So it makes me more confident. It allows me to feel, it encourages me to try new things all the time. So 100% Web3 really allows for me to do that. I mean, I still have interesting parents. They just don't quite understand, but bless their souls, they do try their very best. but they actually noticed a shift as well. Like they even said to me, they said, Andrea, like, we're noticing, you know, your art's evolved so much. And I feel like it has, because you have this community of people that believe in your work and just love what you're doing. And I love that my parents even noticed that. So I think it's really, really cool. And I mean, I that's why I'm here. Like, people ask, you know, that's that simple question we have to ask ourselves when we're entering this space every day. We have to ask ourselves why we are here. And that can change, you know, periodically, over a quarterly period, for example. But my reason stays the same. It's the people. I'm still here because of the community, regardless of sales, regardless if I was working for Join or not. I'm still here because y'all are freaking worth it. I love building with every single one of you every single day. And I know that my next crazy idea, like, some may love it, some may not, but the overall feeling of belonging and acceptance is so powerful here compared to any other experience I've had outside of Web3.
That's great. That's great, Andre. You know, it cracks me up. Web3, like, it just cracks me up. I often hear younger artists say, like, well, my parents don't really understand it. But I'm older. So, and I have to say, and I have adult children, and I have to say, my children don't really understand it. Like, I don't think it's about parents or age. I think it's just like, It's just Web3 is a secret, right? We don't want it to be. We shout from the mountaintops how great it is, and we sell and we tell everybody how great it is. But what 99% of the people just don't really get it. But that's okay. But yeah, your story just really makes me smile, and I think that is so great. That's kind of why I asked the question. So Annie, you wanna go next?
Yeah, I love that she answered what's her favorite thing about the NFT space, which we share in the same light. We love the community and we love the support from the community. And one thing that we love to do as community builders, right? Light Art, Mijamo Art is support artists because of that passion that you have and that you share. We just want to create. And so we're here for that. We love listening to that. Who inspires you? I mean, now you've mentioned about how much you love the space and why, but who inspires you? It could be inside the space or outside of the space. You have someone that inspires you. I'm not sure if we lost Andrea, but we know that she's traveling, so we're having grace.
Yeah, she could be on mute, no?
She is on mute. That's right.
Right. Yeah. See, pretty good. I mean, she may not. Okay. Sorry.
Yeah, you're good. You're good.
Oh, well, how long could a train ride in Ottawa be? I mean, I guess it depends how far out of the city she was, right?
Right. I don't know, but
I
Andrea,
don't think
have
there's
you
any mountains. I don't think there's any mountains there, so I doubt she's in a tunnel. I don't know. Maybe she's going under a river. I don't know.
Hello, I'm
All
still
right,
here.
you're the
Sorry, guys.
experienced one. Oh, all right, there you go. Whew, we killed some time. Go ahead, Andrea.
Tell us who inspires you, Andrea. I think we're losing you a little bit. Oh, I think, yep, we lost
Oh,
her.
she's gone. So let's see if she signs back in. Annie, do you know much about Join? I don't really know. Or is there any somebody that wants to come on stage and tell us a little bit about Join or Andrea's work while we're waiting for her to come back? Oh, she's back.
I think I'm back now. Apologize, y'all.
All
It's
right.
hard to say with trains sometimes. So I heard the question is who inspires me? Is that correct?
That's correct.
Oh gosh, that is a very tricky question because base that inspired me on a daily freaking basis. I wish there could be one person that I could pinpoint to. But actually, I have to, maybe I'm going to start picking names because I'm seeing so many people here in this audience that I can tell you right off the bat who do inspire me. Maheen is actually in the audience. She's one of my really, really good friends here in the space. Actually, this is actually a good person to start with. Her style really, like, it really reflects cyberpunk, cinematic cyberpunk. And I've always wanted to venture down playing around with these genres. And I didn't really start doing that until I started really witnessing what Maheen does. And I just freaking love what she does. And she's damn good at what she does. So actually the piece I pinned up above that you pinned up above for me, which I appreciate, it's actually Maheen that curated me to be a part of the Cinematic Cyberverse exhibit on Super Rare by Space Montage. So she is responsible for that. And I've ventured since then, creating more cinematic and more cyberpunk kind of genre pieces because of her. So I have to say that Maheen is definitely somebody that inspires me on a daily basis to really go outside of my comfort zone. But I also feel like it kind of is in my comfort zone, if that kind of makes sense. It's like I've always wanted to do it, but I was kind of scared to do it. Because again, with being on Instagram, my niche is very much like, about astrology, spirituality, and not so much with cyberpunk. And then I said, you know what, screw it. I freaking love cyberpunk. I love cinematic works. I want to start playing with each of these genres. And so she's definitely someone that inspires me on a daily basis. Like I can give you like a list of over 100 artists right now that inspire me. But I figure since she's here, since she's always supporting me, and the biggest reason that my work is on Super Rare is because of Maheen. So thanks, girl, for always supporting me and having my back.
That's
Very
awesome.
cool.
Very sweet of you.
Okay, so Andrea, what are, is there anything else you're currently working on that you'd like to share? And has the market, has the current market affected your work, or are you still creating irregardless of what's going on out in the outside world?
Oh, I'm definitely still creating. That's definitely, regardless of the market conditions, I'm definitely always creating. But what makes it tricky, actually, like I said in the beginning, I work full time, and I also do a lot of work for Join. So with these two jobs, you can imagine they take up a lot of my time. So unfortunately, I've had to kind of take a step back from creating as much as I used to create. Like on a monthly basis, I used to create maybe 4 or 5 pieces a month. Now it's, if I'm lucky, maybe 2 to 3. I had to really cut it down. So unfortunately, it's one of those things. But nonetheless, I am still creating. The last pieces of work I've done was with Barb. That was at the end of October. In terms of November, I'm more focused right now on seeing what I can create for my collectors for Christmas. So it's typically every year, I give at least 1 or 2 airdrops to my collectors on a yearly basis, for just always for supporting me, my work, and just in general. So I'm looking at doing that, working on some pieces for that. The winter solstice is coming up in December. I always make something for the winter solstice. So yeah, I mean, in terms of large projects, my next big one's probably not going to be until after the new year. There's a big announcement coming from Join very, very soon. I won't give too much information right now, but there may be something coming in January. I like to keep things on suspense when it comes to stuff I do. Yeah, that's all I can pretty much give right now, and more details to come.
That is awesome. I love your collab work. I think it's amazing. And so could you share a little bit about your work with Join and tell us a little bit first about Join? There's a lot of artists here and it's a space for creatives. And so if you would, we elaborate a little bit on Join on the platform.
Absolutely, more than happy to. I'll give a little backstory as to how I even got involved with Join before I kind of get into that, because I find it's an interesting one, and not everybody knows how it kind of happened. So I joined the space, like I said, back in March 2021, and at the time I wasn't looking for another job, but it found me. So Join actually was not originally called Join. We were called Chess Labs. And at the time, the one of our co-founders, Michael, he purchased one of my first pieces on OpenSea. And I was like, who is this guy? Like, who is Chester? Who are these guys? And at the time, at the time, they're like, we just want to help move the space forward. There's so many gaps, there's so many things missing here that are not providing value. Artists are not getting discovered. Let's try and find a way to work together to make that happen. And I was like, I love this. Like, their values, their mission was very much in alignment with what I was trying to do, because I love amplifying artists. I love seeing people thrive, and receiving opportunities for success. So when they came to me and approached me, to see if I'd be happy to work with them, even if it was on the, it was on a volunteer basis, I will be transparent. It wasn't a paid opportunity at the time. And then we kind of, I didn't know exactly where this was going to go. I just knew that energy, I love what they're trying to do for the space, and I wanted to be a part of that. And I grew into what most of you all now know is Join. We rebranded to Join last year around the time of NFT NYC. And at the time, it was our first opportunity where we, our first open call opportunity, with Nympha and with Supercheap. And my work was also exhibited with that too. So that was a huge opportunity, but that was when a lot of things have changed with Join. So for those who are familiar with Join already, you may know Join as the open call platform, but we are so much more than that. So to emphasize further, on who Join is and what we're doing, what our platform offers. So I will note that Join wasn't originally a platform. We didn't have minting and listing capabilities. We do now, but that is because it kind of goes forward with what we're trying to accomplish here and what our mission was to begin with. So really our mission is to ensure that artists have equal opportunities for open opportunities for open calls, contests, et cetera. Because I feel like we all know that discoverability is a huge issue here in the space, and that's one of the biggest things that Join is trying to tackle. So open calls are definitely a huge part of that. artists was, I would say, was our direct audience at the beginning. Then over time, you know, as we build more partnerships, we have amazing curated partner network. Actually, NFT Goat Studios is here in the audience. Stazzy is amazing. He's one of our partners. He does amazing pop-up and real life galleries in Toronto. Maheen also curates and is also doing her own exhibitions as well in Toronto. So those two I work with quite closely, actually, with Join. And they run their open calls on Join. So it's pretty cool stuff. But it's so much more than that, though. Like, on top of opportunities, we want to be able to have the tools and resources for our curators and partners. As we know, you know, doing open calls or doing exhibitions are not easy. They require a lot of work. As a curator, as a writer, in any shape or form, you know, however creatively you're involved in this world, we want to make sure that our platform has the capabilities and features so that you're able to go about supporting artists here in the space. So, like, we have, for example, showcases and stories. So showcases is basically like drops. It's basically meant to be a collection drop. So when we have, for example, a partner who runs an open call and they want to have the works listed for sale, well, you can do a full curation cycle at this point. You have the open call, set up all the pieces for sale, and then you also could write about it. You know, it's not just, you know, setting up pieces for sale. And, you know, as a curator, you may have a story to tell and you want to share more about the curation. And so Patrick Amazon is also one of our partners as well that's really helping enforcing this with the 404 initiative. We recently launched an open call not long ago for curation. So giving everybody equal opportunity to curate their own show. And it was actually the winner of the show was exhibited at Super Cheap Galleries in New York. So these are just some examples of things that we're doing here with Join to, again, provide a full curation cycle for everybody, equal opportunity for everyone to get involved. Whether you're an artist, you want to be a curator for a period of time, if you want to talk about you, your work, you know, we want to give you the platform and opportunities to share more about that. Because I feel like that's something that's very much missing with many of the other platforms that exist in Web3. And I want to compete, but we do want to provide value where it just doesn't exist. And so we're always listening and hearing from artists, from everyone in the space, you know, what is it that's missing and how can we support you on that journey? That's very much the type of work that I do. I'm a community lead and I'm also part of partnerships. So I'm the person that's making connections with everybody here so that I can understand how we can make things better for all of you in your journey. And I'm also seeking opportunities with other conferences, events, galleries, curators all over the world so that we can create even more opportunities for more of you. So that's just to give a nutshell, you know, who Join is, what we do, and what I also do for them behind the scenes.
Well, really well spoken, Andrea. Love the mission, love the passion in your voice. And I can just tell you believe in it. And it's you know, it's hard, right? It's hard to build. Rome wasn't built in a day, and you guys are doing a fantastic job. That's really inspiring. I really enjoy that. So now you talk about lack of discoverability or the importance of having open discovery or the ability for a new artist or any artist for that matter to be discovered. What would your advice be to an artist that, let's say, is maybe a longtime artist, maybe not, but they're in Web3 and they're going through that struggle that so many have about being found and being seen. And maybe your advice would be, well, you know, engage with Join but what other advice would you have for the artist that's just beginning their Web3 journey, let's say?
I think the biggest piece of advice, you know, if we're talking about someone new, really build your community and tribe. I think that is the core of how you're able to find more people who you can connect with and will also have your back. You know, when I first entered this space, that was the first piece of advice I was given. And I still think it is the best piece of advice to give to anyone that's new. Really, really search for those who inspire you. But also give it time. You know, I've talked about this before in previous spaces, actually one not too long ago, is that it takes time to build connections and you need to foster them. You know, try not to treat this as transactional, you know, I support you, so you support me type of situation. No, it doesn't work like that. Like, you genuinely want to make genuine connections with people that you want to connect with regularly. It may not have to be daily, depending on everybody has different circumstances, different lifestyles, etc. You know, meet other people that curate your community, curate the community that you want to be involved with and that you want to spend your energy and time on. and also who are going to understand when you need time away from the space, when you're just not going, you're having a hard time, you know, you want to have those genuine connections with those people to help you through, because it's not always, as we know, being in this space is not always butterflies and rainbows. It's going to have its very dark moments as well. So you want to ensure that the people that are, that you're surrounded by are the ones that are going to be there through the thick and thin. So I think that's the biggest piece for especially newcomers. For those that are been in the space for a long, 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 long time, I've been in the space for 3 years now. And, you know, where I stand now from when I first started is very different. I do believe I have a great community behind me, but I think it's also really important to get outside of those zones as well. I think we get too comfortable sometimes with our current communities. And if we do want to grow, we do want to have more people discover us, we do have to time to time get out of our comfort zone and try and find new people, and try and find other communities that are out there. So I'm in the midst of trying to do that myself. Also, naturally, because I work for Join, it's also pushing me to do that, as I should. But I think it's an interesting kind of perspective, because I'm an artist, but I'm also working for a Web3 startup. So I have these two different kind of worlds, but they're both intertwined. So the things that I'm doing for Join is also helping me as an artist at the same time. It's kind of like forcing me. So it's a good thing, but at the same time, it's like, it's not always my favorite thing to do. It's like, I already have my tribe, I already have my community. Like, I want to stick with that, you know, but as we know, in order for us to grow, we need to get out of our comfort zone. So I think it's interesting how that kind of works out. But that's one of the other pieces of advice for those who have been here for a while. Definitely get out of your comfort zone and meet new people. If you can, I'm not saying everyone has the opportunity, because it is a huge privilege to go to in real life events. Not everybody has that choice. But if you do have the choice to go to in real life events, just go. It is, I can't even explain just how beautiful those experiences are and how many people I've met there that I've been talking to for such a long time, but even just new folks that are within their circles. And I'm like, oh, how did I not meet you before? Like, hey, let's collab. Let's get together. Let's chat, you know? So that's two different pieces of advice for two different places, depending on, you know, where you're starting in this world. That's the best I can give.
You know, I would actually say the advice that you had, well targeted towards new artists, applies to those of us that have been in the space too. It's just a great reminder to just keep, to believe in your tribe, but to also to keep expanding it, like to just not get, you know, too comfortable with just the same core group of people, because then that becomes exclusive. And, you know, I think one of the beautiful things about Web3 is we're all being encouraged, and some of us, a lot of us, are practicing inclusivity and expanding horizons. I know that for me, I have met so many people and that I consider genuine friends that, like, outside of Web3, I mean, like, if they were my neighbors, I would have been friendly and pleasant, but I would have never, like, shared, you know, broken bread with them, shared coffee with them, had a drink with them. I would have just never really got to know them. So I think that's super cool. The other thing I like to preach, to just tie in, and sorry, Annie and Tara, and those of you that have heard this before, but I am a huge believer in real life events, but I always want to clarify, that doesn't necessarily mean you have to spend the time and money to get to somewhere where there's a big in real life event, because we don't all have that ability, especially if we don't live, you know, if we live on a different continent, we can't fly across the ocean just to, you know, a lot of us to just have fun with our Web3 friends. But in real life events can occur in your town, in your community, and it basically anywhere you drive through, there's somebody in Web3 that you can find on X or in Discord or somewhere, and you can set up an in real life event. So for instance, I see Tara's on, and Tara and I had an in real life event about a month ago. We got three or four Web3 of our friends, and we went to a local food cart we live in Portland, and it was a day when it wasn't going to rain, and three or four of us with a couple of our partners came by, and that was an in real life event. We had six people, and the two non Web3 people just had to put up with the rest of us talking about Web3. But I feel like we all left there with positive energy and strength and tribe. So in real life events are huge. And just keep in mind, that could just be as simple as a coffee with somebody you found on X that lives in your community or is in the community you happen to be driving through that day.
Totally agree with you. You build deeper connections with those that you meet, and you meet IRL. But we're passionate about meeting artists and encouraging them and helping them be at one of these IRL events. So if you are in the area or want to know what in real life event is happening, hit us up. We'll find out. We'll connect you. I think that's also part of building community. I think Andrea dropped. And we know she's traveling, so we're grace, grace, grace. But for those of you that are listening and taking the advice here, find people in your community that you can connect with. Even those that you see here that are attending our call right now, find those that are near you or close enough where you can meet up and break bread, like Matt was referring to. Let's see, she's back and hopefully able to speak. And for those that are wanting to know if we are doing an IRL event, we are in Miami. There is a guest list, and we would love to see as many as possible at the Miami meetup. And if we're not, if you can't make it to that meetup, stay tuned with us for sure. We'll find a way to meet up with you guys at another event for sure. But Andrea, can you hear us? I know you dropped. I'm not sure.
Yes,
there we
I
go.
Can.
We have some response.
Yes, I can.
Awesome. In talking with a lot of the things that you're doing already, participating with your tech job, but then also with your joint job, and then doing in real life events and panels and participating in different things, how do you take care of your mental health in this space, the balance that you see fit best works for you that might inspire us?
That is an excellent. Huge advocate for mental health, but I think one of the biggest things I do is takes time away from the space. I know it seems like a very simple answer, and I think it's like the most to me for I guess for most people is common sense, but it's true. I think driver, it's not the number one driver for me. It's going to be different for everyone. So with that said, when it comes to marketing, when it comes to promoting how much time I spend here, I have to be wise with where the energy goes for that, right? Like I was sick with COVID last week, actually, unfortunately. I'm okay now, but at the time I was like, I can't be here to the same capacity as I normally am. Don't even try forcing yourself to do that. That's just not fair to yourself and to everyone around you. So I took the weekend off. I actually take more weekends off than I usually do, but then I feel so much better after that. And as much as at the time, I know for those who, you know, take a day or two away from Twitter, it's like, oh my God, I feel like I've just lost my progress. I've lost my momentum, blah, 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 blah. I truly had to learn how to like completely block that out. I've been hustling and grinding in this space for 3 years, for almost 3 years. So those 3 years are just not going to disappear. That's just not how it works. And I think I've done a pretty good job with curating, like I said earlier, curating the right people in my tribe that will understand when I need to take time off. And they do. So I'm like, I'm creating this illusion in my head that I'm the one causing the problem here. I'm the one that's telling myself that I have to be here. Who is telling me that, Andrew, if you're not here 24/7, like you're not going to make it? But it's like, but what is not going to make it mean to you? That's different for everybody. For me, showing up here and is way more important to me than just simply showing up here and not having a full, like, I'm not here for the right reasons. Like, I want to be on Twitter for the right reasons, in the right headspace so that I can give that love and energy to everyone. And yeah, of course, I'm going to have bad days here and there, and I'm still going to show up even sometimes when I have my off days. But again, it comes down to just being more aware of my energy at the time. And I actually ask myself this question every single morning. I say, how do I feel today? You know, do I feel like I can give the full love and capacity as I did yesterday today? And sometimes that answer is no, and that's okay. I think just being more mindful and aware of what your energy is, like when you wake up in the morning, and being okay with that, being in acceptance of that, I think is a practice. And I don't think it gets easier over time either. I think it's going to be one of those battles that you're going to go through all the time. But I think you need to be kind to ourselves. We need to learn to be better and more kind to ourselves. Take one little baby step every single day. To help you towards, you know, what being in the space means to you, and what can you contribute, and to be in full awareness and acceptance of that. I hope that makes sense what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, 1000%. Really good balance there. Really good. I appreciate that, Andrea. So if there is one thing that Miamo Art and Light.Art, the community, could do to support the Web3 community or the art, specifically artists, that maybe we're not doing or maybe we could do better, what would you like to see?
I think what y'all are doing right now, I mean, with just having these opportunities for myself, not just an artist, but just in my work for Join, and just, you know, being a part of this community for such a long time, I think, you know, doing these types of interviews, like I have to say, I haven't done an interview like this in a very long time. And it's nice to do that every once in a while, but I definitely think being able to give the spotlight to other amazing artists that have not had the opportunity to share their story, I think is huge. And I think it's not, like, this never stop sharing the spotlight with others. And it's truly those who have been in this space grinding and grinding every single day, and to look past, you know, I'm not saying you guys, but a lot of people, and when we see other artists being highlighted, we want to look at those who haven't had the chance to be highlighted. Opportunity I have to share more about me, my story. But I feel that immense amount of joy to be able to give that spotlight to someone else who is also just as deserving, who even if it's somebody who hasn't been here for as long as me, I don't think it's that the quantity of time here is really relevant in this case. We all are people, we all have stories to tell. So I think y'all are doing amazing already. And I think, you know, it'd be really nice if there was going to be more artists that were not fully have so much more to say with their artwork, and not, you know, I find as every platform has their ups, has their own pros and cons, I still think there are a lot of things missing, and I think there's still more that artists can say. So giving them the chance to do that here in your spaces, I think is more than enough, in my opinion. So it's much appreciated what y'all are doing. And again, I'm happy to be here.
Thank you so much. I know Annie's probably dying to get in, but I just want to say thank you. It you know, you take things for granted, but it's like, it's great to hear that get reconfirmed or reaffirmed, because I think especially in Web3, we all have that tendency to move on to the next bright, shiny thing. And we forget, like, there needs to be a foundation, and there's certain things that will always work. And sometimes we're like, well, we've been doing this a while. Should we change and do something different? So I thank you so much. I can't tell you how valuable that was just to hear, like, I mean, sure, keep improving and expanding, but at the same time, this is like, you know, this is one of our main foundational pillars is artist spotlights. And the other one is, I think, events, at least that's my dream. Life events, I just love them. I'm a social person. So thank you so much. And I the reason I grabbed the microphone, I didn't let Annie have it, is I just want to give a shout out to Annie. We don't shout her out often enough. She is unbelievable. She is incredible. She's amazing. And specifically, this shout out is about the people she's getting. She's broadening her horizons. Like, Andrea, I never met you. And so this, I don't think I have, at least maybe in real life, we said hi once, but this is so great. And so I feel privileged and humbled and honored and grateful that Annie has brought us together, and we've been able to spend an hour together just listening to your story. And it's something that I look forward to repeating with new people that we don't know. So Annie, thank you so much for the people you're getting scheduled. It's crazy good. I've had to miss a few lately, and I definitely, been sad that I had to miss those. So with that, Annie, I am going to hand the mic over to you, and you can start managing and handling. I'm sure there's questions and answers and people that want to get up and make comments.
Absolutely. I just want to thank you, Matt, for giving us the opportunity to do that. I follow in your footsteps, and you are a mentor to me. So I'm just honored. And thankful to Andrea for saying yes, and grateful for all those that show up, because we are here for you. We are here for the community, and we do want to highlight the community and give a spotlight for people to share and show their work. And with that said, we do have a Discord where we are now hosting a show and tell. Yesterday, we had our first show and tell, with three artists sharing about their work and their mechanics behind their work. And in our Discord voice chat, which we are planning to do twice a month. And our We're already scheduling for December 4th. If you guys are available, please join our Discord. I'll put more about that here. But moving on to Q&A. For those that have any questions for Andrea, we only have 10 minutes. She's on a train. We want to give her the space to travel without getting rugged. So if two or three of you would love to request and come up, here we have a few coming up already. We would love to hear from you and answer any questions. If you have questions and you can't speak, please write it on the group chat, the thread here, and she can answer afterwards because that chat lives on. So we would love to hear from you, even if you write it on the post here at the bottom. We are putting quotes there and GMs. And for those that are trying to figure out who is the voice behind the Light Art account right now, my name is Abrahani and my face is on here on the bottom. But welcome Ashton and Maheen and Anna. Thank you guys so much for being here and for coming up. First, I'll start with Ashton.
GM. Hope everyone's having a great day, evening, or night. Always a pleasure to be in the Miamo Mart spaces. Y'all always kill it with the interviews, so always a pleasure to be here. I just wanted to say, Andrea, your work is amazing, especially that new collab you did with Barb. And I'm so sorry, I forgot the photographer's name, but that's really... really good project y'all doing. I could tell a lot of work went into that. I didn't even know those dresses were 3D until like you I was reading it and I was like, holy crap, this is like amazing. So amazing collab there. And I just want to say amazing person in the community, always there for people. And just, you know, always giving great advice and always there to help people and show support. And I just wanted to say kudos to you. And that's all I want to say. I know we're running short on time, so I'm just going to keep it short, but awesome work.
I'm sure Andrea is in a spot where she probably can't speak.
Oh no, I can speak. I wasn't sure if you say something first. Ashton, you're the freaking best. I freaking adore you. For those who don't know, I've met Ashton in real life a couple times now. He's in Toronto, so it's only a few hours from me, and same with Maheen. I'm actually on my way to Toronto, you two, but only gone. I'm only here. I'm going to a concert with my family, but I saw Ashton and Maheen actually a couple weeks ago at Maheen's exhibition that she graciously, you know, she put together as her first one ever. So I just love being with the Toronto fam. Y'all are just so freaking incredible. I love you guys like immensely. I heard Ashton, you're already talking with Join behind the scenes, so I look forward to seeing what that's gonna be all about. But Ashton, I appreciate you. I'm a huge fan of your work. You're always supporting the community as well. Nothing but love and respect for you. So I really appreciate you being here and just spreading some love. Always do. Much love, my friend.
Yeah, next up is Maheen. Maheen.
GM. So my girl, Andrea, is here. I'm here to support her, honestly. Firstly, like, thank you, Milim Art, for hosting the space. It's amazing. All the questions that you asked were, like, great questions. I just want to say hi to all my Canadian friends first. Like, I see Ashton, Andrea, Gold Studio, John is here. So we are very tied in, like, Canada. Like, the community here is amazing. Not just, like, you know, the NFT community, like, but, like, we actually hang out. We meet, and I know Andrea is coming to Toronto, I don't know if we'll get to meet, but she's always here in like every month. This space is about Andrea. So I just want to say, like, as an artist, we share these common things together. We both are Leos. We are artists in this space, you know, community builders. You know, she's a curator too. I'm a curator too. So we have these things, and we always discuss, plan, and you know, like ask for each other's advices. And the great thing about people that I really, really am inspired by, Andrea, I know you said you're inspired by me, but honestly, I'm really inspired by you, because it's just like how, like, you know, you create opportunities for others, especially what you're doing with Join, just giving opportunities to artists and like literally just talking to them on one-on-one and like helping them mint their work. Like, you know, it's just so much work that you do. And apart from that, like, you know, just the artists and like how active you are and the kind of support you give to the community, and especially to me as a friend. So just want to say that we're all here for you, and yeah, don't cry. But we're all here for you and to show you support as well. And it was great to hear your story. And I love this piece, Solace. So I'm so glad that it's part of the Cinematic Cyberverse artwork that I curated for Super Rare. And I really wanted you to be part of this, because I knew that we're going to have an exhibition in Toronto. And, you know, I wanted you to be there. And she was on the panel, guys. Like, she did such a great job. She was on the panel. She was a speaker. We talked about community building and all of that for people who missed out. But it was just such a good vibe. And I'm just grateful for all the people, you know, in the community. And yeah, Andrea. So I hope to see you again soon. And I know we are short on time, so I'll just mute myself.
So much freaking love for you, girl. You know that you're my ride or die. You're one of my ride or dies. but you'll see me again, I promise you. I always know you're cooking something behind the scenes, and I'm always like trying to dig in there and be like, what are you working on? If there's anything I can do to help, you know who to call. Those who don't know, a little teaser, Maheen also has something cooking up behind the scenes on Join. I won't say too much other than that, but I'm really excited to see what you put together. Collaboration with, anytime I get to collaborate with you is such an honor, and it's always, it feels easy. It is so easy to work with you, and I think that is also a big part of why our friendship is so strong. We're able to just be vulnerable and talk to each other through the good stuff, the bad stuff. It doesn't matter, you know, anytime you have a success or you're, girl, you just keep going up on a trajectory. Like, you are absolutely killing it, and there's nothing that makes me happier than seeing my friends thrive, grow, and succeed. And I think that's also something that's really important. We talked about earlier about curating your community. When you are succeeding, when you're accomplishing amazing big things, make sure that those same people are also always still rooting for you. I think that's something that's also important to keep in mind. Sometimes we can all get caught up on the sales and everyone else's success. And I can understand, you know, how discouraging that can be from your own standpoint. But I think at the end of the day, we need to be in our own power and realize that we all have our own unique journey. And that's exactly what Maheen will be talking about in her next space. She actually has her own branding about the journey and how the journey is sometimes more important than the destination. That's exactly Maheen's quote. And I still go by that quote every single time. And I tell people, that's my girl, Maheen, dropping all the freaking, like, she knows her shit. She knows her shit. And she even said that on a group panel a couple months ago, that she's like, I know the shit. I will always give you the shit. And you are the shit, my girl. You're amazing. I love you. And thank you for always supporting me.
I love to see that community support. So awesome. Next, we have Anna. Thank you, Anna, for coming up to this space.
Hi, everyone. Hi, Andrea. I just wanted to be here to say how much I love you. So many people already praised you. For those that don't know, Andrea was probably one of my first friends here in the space in March 2021. So we've connected since, and we connected through, you know, our spirituality. She's into astrology. I'm all into anything pagan. So we connected through that, and I love her. But Andrea, we've known each other for almost 3 years, but I don't think I ever asked you this question. You are always doing so much in the community, and I always wonder how you have so much time. So tell me, or us to the audience one or two tips of how you manage your time and get everything done?
It's an excellent question, and I still am trying to give the best answer because I've been asked that maybe a few times over from a few people. And one of the things that I've had to learn with time management, first of all, but then the magic stuff happens. So what I do for myself to make sure that I keep my sanity, because as much as I love to be here and I'm doing my work behind the scenes, I have to give myself breaks in between, as much as that's difficult to do. Like I rely on my calendar. Okay, y'all, I don't think y'all understand. Like my calendar is full. Like when I say full, it's freaking full. When someone says you have another meeting, I'm like, yeah, like you can best bet I have another meeting. Like, and I do have one in the next like 15 minutes. But what I do is I put little spots in my calendar where like it's just a blank space. It doesn't have to be something specific. It can be time for whatever I want, whatever I need in that moment. Does that mean meditation, taking a phone call with a friend? Does that mean I just really make sure that I have pockets in my day that is just for me? I also had to establish much more harsher boundaries with my time. So, for example, that means less time GMing, as much as I'd like to send GMs for other things that take priority. So I've had to reevaluate, you know, where my time is being spent and where it's supposed to be spent. That's been a harsh truth. That's been a little bit more difficult now that I work more. The work I do for Join is increasing, and that's a good thing. That's not a bad thing. We have more partners to attend to. We're onboarding new partners on a weekly, monthly basis. So that means, unfortunately, taking time away from other things, but that's okay. I just, you know, I tell myself that I will find the time when the time is right. So the time management side of things is, unfortunately, you know, being more diligent with where the time is spent. But again, that time pockets in between where it's just time for yourself is so important. Otherwise, it turns into burnout. And I know all my girlfriends here, especially Anna and Maheen, they both know I've been through a lot of burnout in the last 3 years, and they've helped me enforce proper boundaries and making sure that I'm accepting of those boundaries. So these two ladies here that are up here have helped me so much with that. And that's how I've been able to time manage my work a lot better. It's taking time for ourselves, because I feel like we don't do that enough. And sometimes we may be feeling selfish for doing that. We feel like we always have to give. But how can we do that if we're not giving that to ourselves? And these two ladies are prime examples of teaching me how to do that properly. So thank you, girls, for always helping me and just making me a better human.
Oh, how I identify with that challenge. But we love the challenge, and so I get you. Andrea handed me a task that I still haven't completed, and I scheduled it. Just scheduled it for Saturday. More to come on that. Next up, we have John. Hi, John. Welcome to the stage.
Hey, thank you for letting me up on the stage. And yeah, I've been following you, ABM, for a while, and I see all your portrait photography that you your creative photography that you do, and all your mints, and it's really beautiful. In the latest one that you do, and then I saw you created a whole new light and art thing as well, and it was kind of interesting, so I immediately joined and followed that as well, and I also have been following Matt for a while too, and he I think a long time ago he followed me. I was one of his spaces, and Matt followed me and I was like wow, Matt actually followed me, and Miyamo, so I've been following them for a while as well. That's been kind of cool to get a follow from him. But yeah, I want to shout out Maheem too, because I saw that her mint that she launched today sold out in like an hour or two, which was amazing. Congrats on that. And then I also do like Andrea, was amazing. She's been a huge supporter of mine, and she minted another one of my pieces yesterday, which is one of my I'm a landscape, nature, and street photographer in Toronto, Yeah, and she's been one of my biggest supporters for that. So thanks so much, Andrea, for always doing that and supporting my creative vision. And it's been and congrats on all your recent success.
Thank you, John. You know, I love your work. I really, 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 really loved your last one I just picked up. I was like, it reminded me of home, actually. And any piece that can remind me of home is very, very dear to my heart. I will share a little bit of it. I'm actually buying a new, it's called Token Frame. It's basically a huge digital screen. And I'm going to be putting it in my living room, in my home. It's a Christmas present to myself. So I'm very much looking forward to rotating every single one of the NFTs I own, which I do own pieces by you, John. I also own a few pieces from Maheen and from Anna and a few others here in the space. So I will be sharing footage of all of your beautiful work rotating in my home. So thank you again for the three of you. You guys are a big part of my family. I wouldn't be here without my family. So thank you for always having my back and just for all of your love and support.
Great. Thanks so much. Yeah, look forward to seeing it.
That's amazing, John. Thank you so much for showing up and showing the love. It's an honor to have you here. And with that, guys, I am just wanting to say, Andrea, that you are fantastic. You're a phenomenal human, but you are a fantastic artist. And I'm just so honored to have the opportunity to have you here. And I wish you all the best. Do you have any last thoughts?
No, I think that pretty much sums it up. I mean, I always have so much to say. Like, the tribe here knows I can go first. But I just want to say thank you to you and to Matt for hosting this space. And I want to emphasize again just how important these spaces are, especially to all of us creators who just want our story to be heard and to be seen. Sometimes by speaking it out, sometimes can do that. But I mean, ultimately, these spotlight interviews and these spaces are so, so, so important. I hope you continue doing these. And I'm looking forward to attending more of your spaces moving forward. I do like once in a blue moon and when I'm not in a meeting, which is rare, but when I'm not, I do like listening into spaces as I'm working. I love hearing others and their stories. So out of your days, your weeks, your months to give the spotlight to others is so, so important. And it's very, very much appreciated. Giving my friends also to come up here and just be with me. I feel very, very lucky and fortunate and grateful to have such a beautiful community of people that I get to wake up to every single day and just want me to be a better. So thank you again for the time. And thank you to all my friends for being here. I'm getting all emotional. I'm on the train.
That is so cool. You are amazing. And with that, I do want to share that if you want to be part of a show and tell in our very own Discord channel in Discord, please join our Discord and join us for the next show and tell, which you can share more about your artwork, December 4th, hosted by yours truly, Abrahani. And so I did post that on top so that you can go follow and have a little bit of time to join. And and please stay tuned for next space. We are having Spuma. She is part of the Accelerate Art team, and she has been putting on galleries in different parts of the world with the Accelerate Art team. But we look forward to hearing more from Spuma next week. And so please join us for Collector Spotlight next week. And so with that said, we are just so grateful that you came through and that you are here. We hope that you have a fantastic Tuesday. Bye, friends.
Thank you all. Have a great day.